So we worked on Hyperscape for about 2 years. It really started as this core little idea of, hey, let's make a game as a spectacle. And then it grew into this full-fledged battle royale.
I think for us, the core of the team's played battle royales for a long time. Like, it's a genre we play. We still play together daily as a group at night times.
So we really wanted to build a battle royale, one that had its own real Hyperscape flavor and took its own space.
So we took the tension and the intensity of the battle royale, and we really wanted to streamline everything. The fact that the game takes place in an urban environment really changes the moment-to-moment gameplay. You'll be able to navigate the rooftops with your double jump, go from tight interiors to wide open spaces, and so there's a lot of opportunities for cat and mouse action and close quarter combat.
From technical side, we've built what we call a Frankenstein of an engine, where we've taken the best bits from Rainbow Six, the best bits from Assassin's Creed, plus a lot of really hard work from our core engine team,
to build together an engine that's powerful enough to run 100 players in a 1x1 kilometer, all urban environment with great performance all the time.
At the core of Hyperscape, there's really the notion of game as a spectacle, a game that is as fun to watch as it is spectacular to play. In keeping with the notion of an intense and fast-paced game, we really streamlined looting in the game. You will be able to equip 2 guns, but also 2 special abilities that we call hacks. Inventory management is really simplified. You will be able to find items, swap them easily, and then if you find the same item that you already have, you will be able to fuse it together with the one you have in order to improve it. You can do this process 5 times, and then you will have the fully fused version of the weapon. Hacks are really cool. We wanted players to have a toy that they could express themselves with and have a lot of tactical play with. You will have the ability to use hacks as navigation or to protect yourself or to lay traps for your opponents. There are special abilities that promote creative play. Instead of a circle shrinking over time, we introduce the notion of decay. Basically, whole sectors of the map are starting to decay after a while, and you have to go out of them. You will start to notice that some triangles are appearing in the buildings, and you will need to exit this sector before it decays completely. At the last moment of the battle, when all the sectors have decayed, there's 1 sector left, and you enter the showdown. At this moment, we spawn the crown, and you have a choice. You can either win by eliminating all the other players, or you can try and go for a crown victory. We introduce the crown to provide an alternative way to win the game, and a final objective that everyone is fighting for. This creates exciting moments where the last survivors can use different strategies to outplay their opponents.
From the beginning of Hyperscape, the game has been designed with a strong emphasis on the streaming ecosystem. Not only we wanted to make a game that is fun to play, but we wanted to make sure that it supports its streamer and content creators with their communities. Hyperscape Chromecast is the Twitch extension, and unlike any other game extension, it's a tool that we built from the ground up to really support the content creators to engage with their viewers at a whole new level. The Twitch extension is going to evolve with the community. Obviously, the tech test is only the beginning. There's a lot of features already in the works to really strengthen that link between the players, the viewers, the streamer, and we can't wait to reveal those in the upcoming seasons.
Communication updates will be frequent in Hyperscape. We're blessed with a really full schedule from our team. So it's everything from balance updates, gun additions, hack additions, new game modes, new battle passes, new seasons. It's going to give us a lot to talk about, so we're not going to be quiet.
Closing a game is difficult already. Closing a game with lockdown on top is even more difficult. But I see now where we've come together and I really feel like we're a close team now because we're able to do that. You've really seen them drive, you know, and push hard to be able to finish this game. And the best thing for me is not just announcing Hyperscape, it's letting players play it today.